Welcome, welcome, dear student. In a pharmaceutics first practical session, myself, Mrs. Darshana Sandeep Shinde from KK Wagh Institute of Pharmacy, Chandori, Nasik. Today, we deal with the experiment number 29. Title of our today's experiment is to prepare, evaluate, and submit 10 ml of clear shampoo. Learning outcomes of our today's session. After watching this video, students should able to develop the intellectual skills such as to understand the requirements of a formulation of shampoo, to develop the motor skills such as skill for weighing, skill for dispensing polymer, skill to make up the volume. Before starting this session, practical session, we have to know some new concepts like conditioning agent. What is meant by conditioning agent? These are used in lubricating the hair and improve the texture of the hairs. Conditioners or conditioning agent use the texture, improves the texture of the hair. Then surface active agents, the substances which decreases the interfacial tension between the two immiscible substances and enhance their miscibility. Then we see the theory of the cosmetics. Cosmetics, these are any article intended to be rubbed, pour, sprinkle or spread or introduced into or otherwise applied to the human body. Thereof for the cleaning, for beautifying, promoting the attractiveness or altering the appearance, and include any article intended for use as a component of the cosmetics. Our today's preparation shampoo is one of kind of a cosmetics. Shampoos, it includes the nail paints, toothpaste, lipsticks, creams, powders, etc. Then we see the classification on the basis of the parts of the organ of the body and what kinds of the preparation we use. On the skin, we use the creams, deodorants, lotions, powders. Hairs, for hairs, braid softeners, shampoos, shaving preparation, hair colors and conditioners. Nails, in the nails, main manicure preparations like the nail polish and polish remover we use. Teeth and mouth cavity, tooth powders and toothpaste. In a miscellaneous category, eye preparation, insect repellents, creams, etc. we use. Then we see the shampoos. What are the shampoos? Shampoo is a cosmetic preparation used for the cleaning the hair and the scalp. In addition to cleaning, the shampoo perform various functions like the making of hairs more glossy and preventing the excessive drying of the hair. We see the qualities of an ideal shampoo are: a shampoo is a substance. It is capable of removing grease, dirt, skin debris from the hair and the scalp. Amongst that, it should have a non-toxic, it should be non-irritant one. It is effective in a small amount, produces sufficient foam in a hard and a soft water also. It should not make the hand rough and the chap. It should be easily removed by rinsing with the water. All these are the good qualities, or all these are the qualities a shampoo should always have. Then we see the formulation ingredients of the shampoo. Shampoo have the surfactant, conditioning agent, thickening agent, solubilizing agent, opacifying agent, preservatives, active pharmaceutical ingredient is an optional one. Then the labeling of a shampoo should always consist of a secondary label like for external use only, keep away from the reach of the children. It is a medicated or non-medicated one. Then direction for use. Shampoo should always have the direction like the wet the hair or wet the hair with the water, massage shampoo gently on the hair and the scalp, and rinse and repeat if required. Storage, it should be stored in a cool place and replace the cap tightly after its use. Then containers. Shampoos should have the narrow mouth bottle, wide mouth bottle, pouch and plastic collapsible tubes. Then we see the apparatus required for our today's experiment. These are the, we required the beakers, measuring cylinder, spatula, water bath, mortar and pestle, and pipette. Then we see the formulation table required for making of the shampoo. Formulation table, it is an ideal table, or it is an ideal ingredients and its weight, which is prescribed in the specific book. It may be Indian Pharmacopoeia, it may be British Pharmacopoeia, or it may be any kind of the national book. Ingredients of our shampoo are prescribed for the only 100 ml, and today we prepare the 10 ml. For that, we have to calculate the quantity for the 10 ml. For that, we calculate the factor. Factor can be calculated as quantity required upon quantity given. Our quantity required is 10 and our quantity given for the 100. So our factor will be the 0.1. By this 0.1 factor, we have to multiply the each of the quantity given. That means, for an example, 0.1 multiplied by 10, we ultimately get the 1 gram which is required for our 10 ml shampoo preparation. Just like that, we make the all the calculation. Here, perfumes, colors, and water will require the quantity sufficient. Perfumes and colors quantity is quantity sufficient, and purified water's quantity is quantity sufficient to 10 ml. Here, sodium lauryl sulfate is a act as a surfactant. Sodium citrate is a viscosity enhancer. Hydroxypropyl methyl cellulose is a thickening agent. Glycerin as a viscosity enhancer, or glycerin is also used as a conditioning agent here. Methyl paraben as a preservatives, propyl paraben as a preservatives, perfume for the fragrance purpose, color is used as a colorant, and purified water is used as a vehicle. Then we see the stepwise procedure for our today's preparation. Here, sodium lauryl sulfate as a surface active agent used as for the cleaning or cleansing and foaming agent. Sodium citrate is added as the viscosity modifier. Glycerin is added to prevent the dryness of the formulation and as a conditioning agent. Then HPMC is added as a thickening agent. Weigh all the ingredients, solid ingredients, dissolve the sodium lauryl sulfate into 75% of the purified water, add methyl paraben, propyl paraben, sodium citrate, glycerin to above prepared solution. Then add color and perfume to our preparation. Then add the HPMC into the above solution with the continuous stirring for about 20 minutes at the 60 degree Celsius on the water bath. Then we have to cool our preparation, add the water up to the required volume. Category of our today's preparation is shampoo is used as a hair cleansing agent. Storage condition is it should have or mention on the label, that is, replace cap tightly after its use. Then we move towards the laboratory for the actual practical session. Welcome, dear student, in our laboratory session. In this session, we see how to prepare the clear shampoo. Today, we prepare the 10 ml of the clear shampoo. Our formula for clear shampoo is prescribed for the 100 ml, but we prepared only the 10 ml. Today, let's see the chemicals required for our today's practical session. First of all, we require the sodium lauryl sulfate, 1 gram, we already measure it. Then, sodium citrate, 0.1 gram. Methyl cellulose, hydroxypropyl methyl cellulose, which is the 0.3 gram. Then this one is the methyl paraben, 0.18 gram. Then propyl paraben, 0.02 gram. And glycerin, this is the glycerin we already measured, 0.5 gram. And here we use the perfume and coloring agent. And these are the two. In apparatus station, we required the beakers. This is our container, spatula. Let's see how to prepare our solution. Take a beaker. We already measure our quantities, solid quantities. First of all, take a beaker. In that, we take the 70% of the water, that means 7
Here we take the 7.5 ml of the water, add it into beaker. Then add the sodium lauryl sulfate's required quantity, that is 1 gram. Here, sodium lauryl sulfate is used as a surfactant agent, used for the cleaning, foaming agent. Mix it well, dissolve the properly this sodium lauryl sulfate in a purified water. Our sodium lauryl sulfate is dissolved now. Then we add the methyl paraben. Propyl paraben, methyl paraben and propyl paraben are used as a preservative. Then we add the major quantity, that is 0.5 gram of the glycerin into our shampoo. Glycerin is added to prevent the dryness of the formulation. And glycerin here used as a conditioning agent. It gives the conditioning action to our hairs. Then we add the color and the flavor into our preparation. Add flavor into our shampoo. Then we add the sodium citrate into it. Mix it. Now see, our shampoo is getting ready. Little bit one, but we have to required add 1 to 2 reagents into it, that is the color and the hydroxy propyl methyl cellulose. Here there is a choice of color, totally depends on the manufacturer, or type of color usually depend on the which type of the perfume we use. Here we add lemon color, then add the hydroxy propyl methyl cellulose into our shampoo. Dissolve it. For that we require the heating. We added the hydroxypropyl methyl cellulose. To dissolve it, we have to stir it, and we have to heat it up to the 60 degrees Celsius to get a proper dissolve into that. See, our shampoo's appearance, our shampoo is getting ready. Its appearance is clear, and our today's title is that to prepare the 10 ml of clear shampoo. Now we added the color, but our shampoo is, see, the clear one, almost 20 ml. We have to stir it to get the proper dissolution of the hydroxy propyl methyl cellulose. This hydroxy propyl methyl cellulose is added as a thickening agent into our shampoo. Almost 20 minutes we stir it at our 60 degree Celsius temperature, and we see the our shampoo is now getting ready. In that we add the remaining quantity of our water into that, stir it and cool it. After that we submitted, replace it into a suitable bottle. Now see, our shampoo's preparation is cool, and then we measure it into the measuring cylinder. This is our clear shampoo. Its appearance is free from the grittiness. See, it is free from the grittiness. It is perfume one, though we add perfume into it. Its pH is between 5 to 8 and its consistency is semi-solid one. And then we finally we have to prepare, pour our shampoo into the suitable container. This is our clear shampoo now ready. Then we have to label it. How to label, we see in our next session.
Now we see the observation and evaluation table. Observation and evaluation table should be such as, it should contain the name of the preparation, test, specification and observation. Our today's preparation is clear shampoo. Appearance is, it is free from grittiness and it is confirmed. We see in a practical session, our preparation is free from grittiness. Fragrance is perfume, though we add a flavor, a fragrance in perfume into it. That's why it is a perfume one. We passes the test, it is confirmed one. pH, our shampoo's pH is between 5 to 8 and it is, we also confirm that. Consistency, we see our preparation's consistency is semi-liquid and we also confirm that. Then we have to maintain a label just like that. Our label should be contained, clearly mention the all the specifications. That are the first of all, the name of our preparation, that is on the top of the side. Then right hand side, the volume of our preparation should be mentioned. After that, ingredients should be mentioned. Here we mention each 10 ml content, all the ingredients, sodium lauryl sulfate, sodium citrate, HPMC, glycerin, methyl, paraben, propyl paraben, perfume, color, water. All the ingredients we should mention. Then category of our preparation is, here cleansing agent, storage, replace the cap after its use. There is direction for use of the shampoo, that is wait here in a warm water with the water, massage shampoo gently on the hair and the scalp and rinse and repeat if it required. Then also secondary label, for external use only, keep away from the reach of the children, and it is a non-medicated shampoo one. And lastly, at the bottom, name and address of the manufacturer. These are the specifications. We should always mention these on our label of the preparation. Then next segment we see the result. Today we prepare the 10 ml of shampoo. So 10 ml of clear shampoo submitted in a well closed container, replace the cap tightly after its use with the neat label. In this way we finish our experiment number 29. Then we move towards the question answer session. First of all, state four ideal properties of the shampoo. Our shampoo should be non-toxic one, it should be non-irritant, it should not make our hand rough and chap one, and then it should be easily removed from our hairs with the rinsing with the waters. It is effective in a small amounts. All these are the good qualities of the shampoos. The next question is, name the ingredient in above preparation used for the cleansing agent. In the above preparation, well, cleansing agent is used sodium lauryl sulfate, which is a surface active agent, and foaming and cleansing agent we use here. The next question is, what is the advantages does the shampoo have over the ordinary soap used for the hair washing? Our shampoo has the foaming, proper foaming or cleansing agent, then it should have a conditioning agents. That's why our hairs get the glossy appearance, bouncy appearance. These are the advantages over the soap. Soap that cannot be used. Soap cannot be used our hairs the bounciness, conditioning effect. And soaps are not used for the hard water also. But shampoo, we can use the shampoo in the hard water also. Then give three marketed anti-dandruff shampoos. In a market, there are lots of anti-dandruff shampoos are available. Amongst that, Head and Shoulders shampoo, Himalaya Herbal anti-dandruff shampoo, L'Oreal Paris anti-dandruff shampoo, Pantene anti-dandruff shampoo. Lots of preparation we are available in the market. Write the role of the mechanism of hydroxypropyl methyl cellulose. Here, hydroxypropyl methyl cellulose is used as a thickening agent, which use the proper thickening to our preparations and give proper appearance to our preparation, which will be effective in a small dose. So small dose, because of the hydroxypropyl methyl cellulose, our shampoo get the thickened one, and it should be effective in a small quantity also. What is the effect? Can you see if the glycerin is not added in the preparation? Though we know that glycerin is used as a conditioning agent in our preparation, if we do not add the glycerin in the shampoo, our hairs do not get the conditioning effect, do not have the glossy effect, bouncy effect to our hairs. Thank you very much for attending my practical session.